Yes, hello dear friends. In this video, I will explain about the Korean made vessel. And then we will continue with USA National Cargo Bureau grain loading booklet. Okay. First of all, this is draft mark plan. One of example draft mark plan of Korean booklet, Korean made vessel. I will just explain about this. We continue. You see here in the beginning, giving some notes about the booklet. Base of draft mark forward mid and aft is the same with bottom of the keel at midship. Explain here the reference point. So bottom of the keel. Midship draft mark to be marked with steel plate. This is the technical explanation. İşte welding, beasts vesaire etc. like this. And then forward draft mark between 2 meter and 14. Midship between 2 meter and 14. And aft draft mark between 3.4 and 15.1. And here some another explanations about the draft marks. Okay. You see here, this is the aft draft mark plan. Port and starboard same. Here start from 3.4. until 15.1 indicate here. And you see here giving exactly explanation. Basis of the draft mark. Basis of the draft mark from directly below the keel plating. Okay. And then one more important thing here, you see here keel plate at the aft. Aft and forward keel plate thickness is 16 millimeter, 1.6 centimeter. But in the middle it is 17.5 millimeter, 1.75 centimeter. So the keel thickness is not equal in everywhere of the vessel. So here is the baseline. And this is the draft marks directly from bottom of the keel. Not molded draft. Okay. So when you are making draft survey, when you open the booklet, okay, you can see if they apply in the example calculation any keel thickness correction. Same like before I explained before about this, what is keel thickness correction. Same like in Chinese vessels, for example. But here, the keel plate is not same. So, most probably you will not make any keel thickness correction because they directly give you the extreme draft. Also, the draft marks always extreme, don't forget, below the keel plating. Okay. But when you are calculating displacement, maybe need to apply keel thickness correction or not. It depends on the booklet. When you open loading manual, ship stability booklet. Okay. When you open ship stability booklet, in the example calculation, it is right in there. Okay. So yeah, for this vessel, I didn't check actually. But I just want to remember. Okay. About this, if you want to learn, please watch my draft survey English video series. Okay, this is midship draft mark, port and starboard. İşte same, it is explanation. And then here you see below the keel baseline, but here only 17.5. The keel plating thickness. So The forward, aft and the forward part of the vessel, keel plating, is much more thin than middle. Correct. It is not same everywhere in the vessel. Yeah, it is actually a ship construction method. Okay, that is why they make the mid thicker, stronger than forward and aft. Anyway, and this frames in the middle of the vessel. I just want to draw here. For example, this is my vessel. Okay, like this. The frames, the distance between the frames, it is going like this. But when you come to forward, they put the frames much more closer each other, also same in the aft. Okay, much more closer. But when you come to middle, they much more separate, and this distance is not equal here and here. This is longer, these are shorter. Because of the vibration and also forward with the hitting by the waves, okay, that is why they want to make here stronger normally. But middle, the distance between the frames much more longer. But you see here the keel plate thickness is thicker than forward and aft. Okay, this is a ship's construction method. They indicate here, but anyway, I just want to mention. Okay, we continue. Okay, this is the forward draft mark. Also, you see the in the middle thicker, in the forward not same. Also, much forward, they also increase. You see here 2.2 centimeter. Because this area, değil mi? Here bulb area always hit by the waves. So that is why they make here much more stronger. Anyway, but same. It is bottom of the. You see here the base of the draft mark. Bottom of the keel plate. And you see here is the distance between the forward perpendicular and the draft mark. Here, in this drawings, don't forget always millimeter. So this is 9040 millimeter makes 9 meter 4 centimeter. Okay. This is the freeboard mark plan. We continue with this one. The next plan, you see here they give some principal dimensions, işte length, breadth, length overall, between perpendiculars, etc. They just give here. You see here they just explain about the freeboard mark from port side, for example. You see here this drawing is very clear. In there, don't forget here the top of the this line is the center of this film soil mark. Okay, don't forget. Always up. You see summer up and fresh water here. So this is my summer from top. So this distance here. This one, and this one, this distance is the fresh water allowance. From the fresh water, top of the fresh water here, and then top of the summer line. So between this one, 289 millimeter. So 28.9 centimeter, almost 29 centimeter in this vessel fresh water allowance. Okay, and this is, you see here, summer same line with the film soil mark. You see here, same. Don't forget this. The middle of the film soul mark is the summer line. Always. And the top, not the middle. Don't forget. This is the half circle. The other part is half circle. Okay. But center of this circle here. That point. Okay. Not bit down. Always up. Don't forget this one. And this distance, summer to top of the freshwater line, this one. You see, there is a gap between tropical. Not the tropical. I mean the freshwater line. Here. You see here. Top of the freshwater. Not this one. This is the freshwater elements, this distance. You can find where you can find ship specifications. For example, you go to shipyard and you will prepare a ship particular. I recommend you use one of the previous vessels you worked before. You use that ship's particular as tentative one. You erase all the information, only the titles remain, and then you just start fill up with this one, okay? But you have to check the tables, booklets, everything. Okay, you can, for example, where will you find the freshwater elements? Here you can find. Okay. And this is ballast water management plan. Okay, one of the examples. You see here is the ballast capacity. Here. Hole number 3 ballast capacity here. Segregated ballast tanks here, because when you go any country, they will send you to fill their ballast water exchange form. So when you need to fill that form, you need to write. They will ask you total number of segregated ballast tank on board, number of other tanks that may be used for ballast, number only one tank. Okay, so you can find all the information from the ballast water management plan. You will find from there all the official information. Okay, so normally you must fill according to this one. And what is written here for the ballast tank, you must write this one, don't forget. Okay. This is tank capacity and tank arrangement plan. Okay, this is the capacities, official capacities in cubic meter. Okay, what I recommend you, when you join a vessel, and then when you make ballast exchange first time, maybe you use the previous ballast exchange forms for the capacity. Okay, I don't recommend this one. Because the previous officer maybe make mistake, handwriting mistake. So you just open the ballast water management plan and then fill from here, don't forget. Okay, also the pump capacity right in there. Okay, yeah, I have already talked before about this one. You see here light ballast condition, here heavy ballast condition, but you see there the fluid hole number 3, but also the DBT and the TST hole number 3 also full. You see after peak also full, but fore peak is slack. Yeah, this is the official way. But when you make like this, the heavy ballast condition, most probably you will see your bending moment is very very high. Because when you flute hole number 3, if you not pump out DBT and TST number 3, okay, it will increase the bending moment too much. Even if officially written there. So according to your fuel condition, don't forget. Before, if you have to make heavy ballast vessel according to your fuel condition. Okay. Also fresh water, anything. Don't forget. Before you start this operation, make a plan according to this one. What will you consider here? If you need to, when you make this hole number 3 full, if you need to pump out number 3 and number 2. Because also consider the voyage, don't forget. Okay, maybe initially your fuel oil tanks are here, maybe they full. Okay, you make bunkering also. Here is some weight, correct, and it will push down. But during the voyage, they will consume this fuel. This tank will be empty, correct. And then it will not push down anymore. So it will affect your middle strength, correct. Huh. Because the ballast water will still remain here, so it will affect too much force. Correct. Huh. So, what I recommend, what I was doing always, if I fill my hole number 3 with water, I pump out TST and DBT number 3. Okay. But what I recommend you, please check the stress. If stress very high, and what I think maybe more than 95% bending moment, okay, you just make empty TST and DBT. Okay, how you make, I explained before, okay. Because this operation, ballast operation for heavy fuel, in this ballast water management plans, nobody tell you how, okay, they will write in these plans, exchange of light ballast condition or exchange of heavy ballast condition, but nobody tell you how will you make vessel heavy ballast condition from light ballast condition. Okay, you are in the port, you are in light ballast condition, maybe how will you make your vessel heavy ballast condition, or if you are heavy ballast condition, how will you go for light ballast condition? This operation writes nowhere. So, as a chief officer, you have to make ballast sequence plan. Okay. So, what I was doing, just this is theoretically, you must check for your vessel. Ship-specific operation actually, this is. Okay. So, but what I was doing generally, okay. I am in light ballast condition, correct. And I will make my vessel heavy ballast condition. You see here, after peak is empty. Okay, at first, I overflow my after peak. I make it full. Just keep the fore peak like this. Okay, it is half. Okay, no problem. And then, I call engine room. Please switch off the valves for seawater main line. Okay, all the main lines for ballast water line, okay, switch off, they close the valves. Okay, at first I open my fluiding manhole valves for hole number 3. Okay, I open, and then I open also the valve of the TST number 3, port and starboard. What will happen? By the gravity, this water will go to engine room and then will start fluid hole number 3. Okay, by the gravity. Okay, and what I recommend you, even if you will make pumping for hole number 3, at first use gravity. Why? Because this fluidic manhole ballast valves, correct, coming like this. Like this. And here some valves, for example, valves are here. These two valves generally not always use, very very rare, correct, maybe one time in 1 year, maybe in 2-3 years you operate only for one fluiding operation. So if you directly use the ballast pumps and these two valve or one valve, it depends on the vessel, if not open you will damage the pump. So okay, you open this one, even if you want to use the pump, At first use gravity because you make sure water coming so your valve is properly up. Okay. And then anyway we continue. And then I open this one by the gravity. It start to fill hole number 3. Easy easy. Maybe coming. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe 1 meter something. Anyway. Okay. I make empty my 4 pick. Correct. Ha. And then I fill up until the top. I make full hole number 3. Hole number 3 finish. Finish. Ha. And then I pump out my DBT port start. Okay, this is what was I doing. At first, by gravity, this TSD water send in the DBT, and then by the pump, make full hole number 3, and then finally pump out DBT port starboard. Okay, this is a general operation, and then check the level of the four pick. It is important because for the bending moment. Okay. Also don't touch the after pick anymore. Okay. Must be some weight here. Heh. Also consider the fuel consumption something I tell you before. Okay. This is what I was doing when I were working on board. Okay. When you join any vessel, always read this ballast water management plan. First priority, okay. What I told you before, when you join a new vessel as a chief officer, at first opportunity, maybe joining day night or maybe one day later, but as soon as possible, read your grain loading manual, ship stability booklet, and then ballast water management plan. Okay. Why? Because you see here some notes, some explanations, some warnings here. Okay. So when you need to make, when you can make ballast exchange, or when you must not make the ballast exchange because of the safety considerations. Everything right in here. Minimum draft forward, pump capacity, exchange, everything, some warnings, some advices, guidance, everything about the ballast operations right in here. Okay. You see here some safety considerations, limitations, when not safe, ballast exchange, because also ship specific, what kind of ballast exchange operations you can make. Also write in here empty refill or flow through, which one officially you can make here. So you see here some empty refill method in heavy water, işte in temperatures for the congested or narrow waters, for the visibility purposes, for the sequential method means empty refill method. So you must not make ballast exchange in that conditions. So everything right in here you must read. Also you see minimum draft forward, lowest draft forward in normal ballast condition, in heavy weather, raw seas, minimum draft forward, everything right in here. So you, if you are sailing in heavy weather conditions, if you want to make ballast exchange, maybe your draft forward will reduce until 3 meter, 2.9 meter. So it will not safe for your vessel. So in that conditions, in the heavy weather conditions, you must not exchange your ballast water for the safety of the vessel, crew and ship's property, everything. So you must, okay. When you make ballast exchange operation, actually same like loading and unloading sequence. Okay, for cargo operations, what we are making? Loading sequence or unloading sequence. Why we are making this one? Because considering the ship's stability. Okay, you must make same thing for the ballast exchange operations. Before your ballast exchange, you must make a plan, sequential plan. for the ballast exchange operation and you have to see what is your bending moment, shearing force, visibility, draft, forward. If the weather is good, calm, okay, no problem. Even if your forward draft maybe 2.5 meter, if there is no weather, okay, it is no problem. But in raw sea condition, you cannot reduce your forward draft. Then minimum draft forward. Okay, maybe you can damage the vessel. Okay, so these are important things. Don't forget, same like loading, unloading sequence, ballast exchange. For ballast exchange operations, you must make a ballast exchange sequence plan. And you print out from this one, because some of the port state control officers sometimes asks. Also some, when class surveyor come on board, okay, they also ask this one. Okay, they tell you, show me your exchange, ballast exchange booklet. Okay, you show them. And then, okay, they ask you, where is your plan about this one? Okay, it is also important. You see, here is right. Allowable shearing force, bending moment, cannot be exit. Minimum GN, you must consider draft forward minimum. Also visibility, length overall or 500 meter. It is not written here, but visibility according to SOLAS cannot be the blind zone in your forward visibility. Okay, I explain about this one. For example, okay, I draw like this one. Yeah, I order my graphic pad, but there is some problem with the cargo company actually, so it didn't come yet. I am waiting, I call them. But anyway, I think with the next video, I will use graphic tablet. Okay, anyway, this is my vessel, correct. This is the superstructure and the bridge. What they mean? This is my center line, correct. Huh. From the conning point, okay, here. I draw it from the conning point, don't forget. What is the visibility? 10 degree port side, 10 degree starboard side. Okay. This is 10 degree, 10 degree, total 20 degree. This area, okay, and I draw one vessel here, but very small vessel. Like this. This is my superstructure. Okay. This is the bridge. Okay. This is the vessel. This visibility area going like this, correct. Huh. So because of this one, for example, here is the sea level also. Okay. This distance from forward and the sea level. Okay, I draw like this here and pardon. Here, that distance cannot be, because this is blind. Here, you see your bridge is there, your forward is there, and this area, I change the color. I make green. Okay, correct. This area here. Is blind. You cannot see that area. Correct, huh? This area. So, this distance, okay, here, until there, it's coming like this. It is like this, going like this. The visibility line is going like this from bridge, that area. Here. This area is correct here. cannot be longer than two ships length. But for example, if your vessel length is 150, so pardon, if your vessel length is 300, for example. Okay, two vessel length make 600. Correct, meter. Huh. If your vessel, two vessel length is more than 600, cannot be, this distance cannot be more than 50. Okay, which is less? 500 meter or two vessel length? Okay, that is why, and this is 10 degree here, 10 degree here, 20 degree. Okay, port side 10 degree, starboard side. What is the visibility area means that? Okay, don't forget. 10 degree here, 10 degree here. Total 20 degree. This visibility area cannot be more than two vessel length or 500 meter. Which one is shorter? Okay. That is why when you are making, if you are in light ballast condition, so you must consider also this SOLAS regulation here. Okay. Also draft trim range. Damage stability was considered in trim range. Yes, trim range here. You see. Ben empty. Because sometimes really your draft forward becoming 2 meters, 2.5 meter, 2 meter. Okay. You have to consider too much thing. So you must you make your exchange plan, sequence plan by the Loadmaster computer. You see all this criteria is okay. Stability, bending moment, sharing force, işte GM, draft minimum forward, everything is okay. You see here, they explain here. So for that vessel, two ships length. Okay, ha, this is another thing. Okay, so also this one, propeller immersion. You have to consider also the propeller immersion. Okay. When ballast exchange in raw sea condition, propeller must sink in the water. Also, if it is too much outside, you will damage the engine also. It is important. Okay. And I want to tell you one important thing. Okay. So, you remember in the top of the booklet, previous pages, it is written this vessel have two pumps and each pump have 900 capacity. But you see here explanations. Şimdi in this booklet, in each ballast water management plan, they will give you for light ballast condition and for heavy ballast condition some ballast exchange plan. They already give you. But you see here, one thing is very, very important. Simple estimated time based on pump capacity 890 cubic meter per hour means 90% pump efficiency. This pump efficiency is very, very, very critical. Why? Because don't forget, even for that vessel, for example, your pump capacity 900 cubic meter per hour, you see they officially use 90%. Why? None of the pump can run 100% capacity. Okay. So for example, when you go to Australia, agent will send you some Australian ballast water exchange requirement booklet. For example, when you check that booklet, they tell you this one. You cannot use 100 capacity of your ballast pump. You cannot use 900. For example, you exchange one ballast tank. Its capacity 1800. Okay. So you write the ballast water record book. My pump is 900. I pump out this one in 2 hours. Okay, you will take penalty because they will expect this one 90% pump efficiency, pump capacity. Okay, so you have to use 810 cubic meter per hour. So for example, let's say I don't calculate now, but let's say 200 2 hour 10 minutes. Okay, 210 minute exchange time. It is very very important. Also don't forget. What I was remember, I think it was in Australia also again. For example, you take new vessel, okay, from the shipyard. Okay, directly new vessel. This pump capacity 90%. You will take. Okay, we make like this. You join, you take one new vessel from shipyard. Pump capacity 1000 metric ton per hour. Okay, my pump capacity new vessel 1000 metric ton cubic meter per hour. Okay. So when you make ballast exchange records, you will use 90%. Okay, so you will use 900. Correct, huh? But for each year, they tell you 1% also reduce. For example, my vessel is new, I will use 900. But for example, my vessel is 2 years old. So 2% of this 180 how many cubic meter it makes? Just a moment. I just calculate. 18. So 900 my full capacity. For each year 1% I reduce pump efficiency also. Also, so it's 2 years, let's say 2%. Divide 100, multiply 2. So minus 18. So 900 minus 18. I will use this one. Okay. Cubic meter per hour. For example, let's say my vessel is new 1000. But I will use 90%. Correct. Pardon. I will use 90%. It's made 900. For example, my vessel is 7 years old. Correct. For each year minus 101. Yeah, actually not like this, but anyway, you just make like this. So how many years? We say 7 years. Okay. So multiply 100, divide 100, multiply 7. So 63,900 minus 63, 837 cubic meter per hour. Don't forget this one. Okay, so even if written here 1000, for example, in the booklet, you have to use this. Okay, don't forget this one. All the, for example, if you are making flow through method, correct, so 300 times, 300% you exchange your ballast with flow through method. Especially for the flow through method, they want you to use that capacity. You cannot use directly your full capacity because of this pump efficiency headache. Okay, don't forget this one. Not every port, not everywhere, but for the Australia, they are very sensitive. Okay, don't forget this one. This is very very important. Okay, you cannot use 100% of your pump capacity because of this pump efficiency headache. Okay, don't forget this. Also, when you go to a loading port, for example, if they are very fast, making very very fast loading. Okay,
You can tell them like this. Okay. Yani you don't make your calculations with 100% of your ballast pump capacity. Don't forget. This is very very important. You see here exchange for light ballast condition. This is just example. They all you see here they write the time also. Also here. So you see total exchange time empty refill method for the light ballast condition 20 hour 54 minute. Okay. Yeah, it is just a general rule. Okay. Don't forget. If anybody asks you what is your ballast exchange time? Yeah, in Chinese vessel, in Japanese vessel, this is Korean made vessel. When I check this ballast water management plans, it is always 21 hour. Don't forget this one. Just automatically you can tell them 21 hour. Okay, if you didn't read this booklet. For the empty refill ballast exchange time in light ballast condition, don't forget. Okay, it is a just general rule. It is better you check officially what is written there, but just general rule, don't forget, 21 hour. Okay. Also, when you go a loading port, if they ask you what time you need to pump out your ballast, also it is 21 hour. With full pump capacity, including stripping. Don't forget. Okay, all the ballast time I need from start to finish, main deballasting and then including stripping 21 hour. But you just generally tell them 24 hour. Okay, it is always better. But if they insist too much, how many hour you can reduce? Okay, minimum 21 hour. Don't forget. Not less than 21 hour. In one of the charter, in one of the port, because they too much insist. Okay, they ask 18 hours, if you can make 18 hours, something. I tell them 21 hour. Okay, they ask for calculation. Okay, so it is not only for ballast exchange, also for this trade cargo. Pressure, port operation pressures. Okay, you must check your ballast exchange, ballast water management plan. Because they ask me for the calculation. Okay, I open my booklet. I show them 90% pipe efficiency. This is because officially written there. Okay, and then this is my tanks. This is my ballast on board. This is my pump out time. This is my stripping pump. This is the capacity. And this is the total time. I need 21 hour and nobody can tell anything. Okay. Because sometimes they want to go until the limits. Okay. So you must check also this one. This booklet is very very important. Don't forget. Also this is exchange for heavy ballast condition. Including hole number 3. Okay. So you see here is some notes. İşte for after peak. Fire and GS pump. Single pump is available. Okay. Also don't forget this one. In some of the vessels you cannot use ballast main pump for after peak. This is very very important. If you calculate all the capacity for deballasting in loading port including after peak directly with the ballast pump, main ballast pump, it will be not correct because your fire and GS pump is less capacity. Okay. Also, because if you use this one, you cannot make stripping also. Don't forget in some of the vessels because this ballast line characteristic and ballast pump characteristic, you must know very very well. Okay. Because in some of the vessels, they give for example port starboard ballast main line. Also, additionally, port starboard stripping line. Okay. But some of the vessel only one line they give you. And you use for main deballasting and stripping only one line. Okay. So, also this after peak. In some of the vessel, you can use main ballast pump. Some of the vessel, you cannot use. For example, in that vessel, if you make stripping with FireJS pump, and if you use after pick to pump out with the FireJS, you cannot make stripping also. Okay, these are very very important things. That is why you have to analyze this ballast water management plan very very well. What is your ballasting characteristic of the vessel? Okay, it is very very important. You see, for the flow through method, tanks for which the flow through method should be applied. You see, flow through method only considered for hull number 3. For example, for that vessel, you cannot record, I make my ballast exchange with flow through method. Okay, don't forget. It will be also another headache. What is officially written there, you must record as officially what is written here. Okay, don't forget. It is important. Even if you make flow through method, okay, even if you make in practice, unofficially, but officially, you must make all your records as ballast water management plan. For example, only hull number 3 for that vessel. You cannot tell, I make my topside number 2 exchange with flow through method. You cannot. Okay, don't forget this one. Even if you make actually like this. Yeah, okay, I will finish this video. It is already 46 minutes. So this booklet is like this. Okay, ballast water management plan. We continue with the next video. Thank you for watching.